Assalamualaikum, apa khabar Hujung Santri? So, apa yang kita akan lakukan hari ini ialah saya akan menanyakan soalan-soalan yang sedikit pedas berkaitan dengan Mitsubishi Xpander yang kita lihat di belakang ini. Sebuah crossover yang telah dinanti-nantikan sejak berapa lama oleh rakyat Malaysia. Okey? Dan hari ini saya bersama dua orang gentleman ni. Di sebelah kiri saya ialah Tomoyuki Sanishi, iaitu CEO untuk Mitsubishi Motors Malaysia. Dan rakan lama saya ni, Hoffman Teh. Hoffman Teh ialah Senior Vice President juga untuk Mitsubishi Motors Malaysia. Can you explain to me what are the key selling features for this Xpander?
Okay, let me explain the key unique sales point of the Xpander. First of all, I'd like to say that this Xpander developed for the ASEAN countries. Mm. So, starting from introduction in Indonesia, other regions, so the Philippines, Thailand, and the Vietnam, all of the countries, this Xpander sale is so successful. Mm. Mm. So, developed for the ASEAN countries. And then, for the Malaysian Xpander sale, I'd like to highlight three major unique sales points. Mm-hmm. One sales point is that very well advanced and futuristic design.
Ah, okay.
Yes. As you can see that the Xpander face is showing our dynamic shield design. Mm-hmm. Currently, all of the Mitsubishi products using this dynamic shield design. So we have the strong confidence with this futuristic design. Second unique sales point is a spacious body. Mm-hmm. So this car is good enough for seven adult people to sit in the Xpanders. Mm-hmm. So this is also the good second point. And the third point is that on top of this two these unique sales point, we adjust a little bit this car for the Malaysian's taste. For example, we installed a special leather seat and also 9-inch monitors and also all-round monitor also we installed.
9-inch
monitor? Yes, that's right. I think this is the biggest monitor size in the segment. And yes, digital video recorder also we have. Mm-hmm. Such an entertainment system we have in this Xpander.
I see.
Yep.
So, three interesting things about the Xpander. Mm. Ada tiga tadi yang Shinichi San sudah sebutkan. Okay, soalan seterusnya ialah ni semua orang tanya, kenapa baru sekarang Mitsubishi nak perkenalkan Xpander? So, kita tanya kat diorang. Eh? Mm. So, sir, why only now Malaysia is getting the Xpander?
Like speaking, this is due to the CKD model. Mm-hmm. So, it takes a time. So you know that one of the very unique points of Malaysian car industry is that we have the special taxation scheme. So in order to make the model more competitive, all of the car should be CKD basis. So our Xpander is CKD. Mm-hmm. So the Malaysian's assembly basis. So mm-hmm. it takes a time to introduce to this car to the Malaysian market.
So the reason is because you need to make sure that there is enough local components for the
Yes, vehicle? That's right.
Mm. Okay, now, suspension belakang untuk Xpander ni, apa yang saya diberitahu ialah ia menggunakan torsion beam.
Betul.
It uses a torsion beam setup, right? Okay, now, kenapa torsion beam? Sebab ada yang pakai multi-link. Ada yang kata torsion beam ni is too simple. There's less parameters for you to tune. So, kenapa guna torsion beam?
The first thing is that there are benefits for the torsion beam. Torsion beam, this mainly vehicle designed for the Southeast Asian market, it's slightly advantage in the sense of the softness. We're talking about ride softness. Can be better in terms of the multi-link. But of course, in order to make sure that the entire vehicle maintain the stability and also the ride comfort, the important part, the next part of it, is to call the absorber side. So it's a matter of tuning balance between the shock absorber and also the torsion beam setting. So in this case, I think the usage of this shock absorber together with all these so-called experience by Mitsubishi Motors in terms of the ride suspensions has made the whole car packaging in terms of the rear part, enough space for the 7-seat, and also just to cater for the city driving and some adventure in terms of the adaptations of the modulations of the vehicles. So that is the key part of it.
Hmm, dengar tu. I agree with you. In fact, kepada siapa yang suka nak kutuk torsion beam tu, bear in mind, Renault Megane RS pun pakai torsion beam. Your beloved Proton Iris yang handling dia, korang kata sangat mantap, also uses torsion beam. So basically, the setup berpulang pada engineer, jurutera boleh buat apa yang dia nak dengan apa-apa jenis setup tu. Betul ke tidak? Dia menggunakan ada sedikit komponen Lancer Evo di dalamnya. Betul tidak?
Yes, the answer is correct. Like just now I mentioned, in terms of the absorber, tuning is very important. And in terms of the absorber setup, one of the key things in terms of the shock valve, it is the same components that's carry over from the Lancer part of it. So the whole absorbers play the role of absorbing in terms of the tire movement and the vehicle bounciness on that basis. So that plays one of the, let's just say, the know-how of Mitsubishi's engineers in tuning from our so-called rally and then always towards this on-road usage.
So tu dia, memang ada, dan paling penting sekali penelaan yang mereka belajar daripada membuat Evo tu digunakan juga untuk expander. Kalau anda dah tengok video Triton kita orang dulu, kita pun memang memuji handling Triton tu. Memang I think it's one of the best in the pickup truck world, especially if you go fast off-roading. The suspension is wow. Okay, soalan pada seterusnya. Sini Sisan.
Yes.
What is the benchmark that you use during its development?
Oh, I see. Okay, so actually for this Malaysian market, our direct competitor is Honda BRV and also the Toyota Rush. So it is a 7-seater. So I don't know what they call so SUV or MPV. This is our direct compete.
This is what you call a crossover.
Yes, that's right.
So dia mengaku seteru utama dia ialah Honda BRV dan Toyota Rush. Dan soalan paling last kali, my final question for you guys.
Yeah.
Mitsubishi Motor Malaysia before this has been assembling cars here in Klang Valley, but now you have shifted to Pekan, Pahang. Which is a few kilometers from where I was born.
Oh, really? Okay. Good. Interesting. Good place.
So, why Pekan? Why do you want to assemble this in Pekan?
So, frankly speaking, this is a we did our business decision. So, in terms of the business feasibility, we decided to produce this car in the Pekan factories, and you know that. Our one of the shareholder is a DLB Group. So in Pekan, they have the very big car industrial areas. So in this occasion, we fully utilize our shareholder's facilities with a competitive condition.
I see.
On top of that, taking these opportunities for this expander project, we Mitsubishi Motor Malaysia and also Mitsubishi Motor Japan established new joint venture company to make this model more competitive and make this model more better quality level.
So you created a new company just to assemble this?
Yes, that's right.
As supporting in terms of the production part of it.
I see. Wow.
And in addition, if I may add, the Pekan plant is also what we consider when doing our feasibility study as a fantastic paint shop facilities. So what you have seen now is that our vehicles offer the four varieties of colors, and one of the colors considered challenging is the diamond white, which is a pearl effect. So such of the paint shop effect was easily done in one of the latest, let's just say, facilities in terms of the technologies offered by the Pekan facilities for the top coat painting.
So right now, how many people in Malaysia have put down their money on this car, on the expander?
Booking. From today, we will start to officially to open the booking now. So, but we already started gather the interest through our official website. We already gather the interest of the customers. And then until today, we already got 7,400. interest register to our Excel website. So this is much better than our expectation.
So lebih daripada 7,000 rakyat Malaysia telah menunjukkan minat mereka kepada Expander ni. Dan when can they start to book the vehicle?
Starting from 22nd of October. So yes, very near.
So start hari ni kau nak boleh booking Expander ni. Alright gentlemen, thank you very much. And I wish you guys good luck. I believe that you guys have a perfect MPV formulation, and I think a lot of us have been waiting for this. Thank you very much. All the best.
Okay, thank you very much.
Jangan lupa subscribe channel kami dan tekan butang loceng supaya anda tahu bila video baru kami akan muncul.